Hello friends, I'm Dr. T, and today we're going to start a new series entitled The Secret to Better Health, The Magic Pill. What if you could avoid heart disease? If you could avoid high blood pressure, high cholesterol, metabolic syndrome? You could avoid diabetes, insomnia, weak bones, osteoporosis, back pain. If you could prevent falls, you could prevent 8 type of cancers. What if you could control your weight, brighten your mood, fight depression, sharpen your memory, improve your sex life, and maintain your independence and decrease your healthcare costs? Would you do it? I certainly would. I'm in fact doing it, and you can do it too. The magic pill does not cost a bundle. It's not a pill, and it's exercise. And today we're starting a series of videos on this magic pill. We'll explore its wide ramifications. And today we are asking these questions. What is physical activity? What is exercise? What is fitness? What's included in physical fitness? What are the types of exercise we're talking about? And how fit are you? Let's start with question number one. What is physical activity? Physical activity is any movement of the body involving skeletal muscle contraction that causes energy expenditure above the baseline. The baseline energy expenditure is equivalent to 1 mass. Exercise is a type of physical activity, but it is planned, is purposeful, organized, with intent of improving one's health. This is really the ability to do your activity of daily living, and participate in leisure activities, respond to emergencies with energy and vitality without excessive fatigue. What is deconditioning? It's a state of health that occurs from inactivity and lack of exercise, leads to a functional loss. And here, the old maximum comes to play. Use it or lose it. Question number four. What's included in physical fitness? Again, we have cardiorespiratory, abbreviated by cardio, muscle strength, flexibility, balance, body composition. Question number five, what are the types of exercise we're talking about? Let's look at aerobic or cardiovascular. The body large muscles move in a rhythmic manner for a sustained period of time. What about strength or resistance exercise? Any exercise causes your muscle to contract against external force that is going to lead to increased lean body mass, improved muscle strength and endurance. What about flexibility? Is a range of motion this possible in a particular joint? It depends on the ligaments, the tendons, and the muscle tightness. And what is balance? Balance is the ability to withstand destabilizing forces or postural sway due to self-motion, environment, or objects. The skater lost his balance and fell. What is body composition? Is your lean body mass and the amount of fat in your body. How fit are you? Well, the fitness is assessed in these four key areas, the aerobic, the muscular, the flexibility, and the body composition. But let's just look at the aerobic fitness. What is aerobic fitness? The gold standard is the VO2 max, maximum oxygen consumption, but this requires special equipment and is expensive. There are other ways of obtaining your cardio fitness, like if you walk for 1.5 miles or run and time yourself, you could compare that with others in your age group and so on. There is the Cooper test, where you run as fast as you can in a flat surface for 12 minutes, and then you plug your time, your gender, your weight, and the height in the formula, gives you a number. But what if you can't run for 12 minutes? Let's just do a simple test. Just pick a distance that you can walk or run as fast as you can, and let's say even 100 meters or 400 meters, and use your timing as a baseline to see how much you are improving in the future. Muscle strength. The classical way is using a hand grip test, for instance, and flexibility is a sit and reach test. What about body composition? Calculate the real amount of fat in your body, and there are complicated ways of doing it, expensive ways, but if you look at the body mass index, the BMI, is essentially your weight in kilograms divided by your height in square meters, will give you an idea where you stand. Normal BMI is between 18.5 and 24.9. Ideal, it should be in the 22-23 range. A 60 kilogram person, for instance, 5'5 height, will have a BMI of 22. In summary, we look at the extraordinary benefits of the magic pill. The benefits are real, they're well documented scientifically, they're available to everybody. Just do it. And if you want to know if it's safe for you to exercise, please check this video, cardiac arrest in athletes, top two warning signs. I'll put a link. And remember, your health is too important to be delegated to others. Let's just take control. If you like this video, subscribe to my channel, write a comment. I really need your advice. I publish these videos on the second and fourth Friday of each month. See you next video.